Good morning, everybody. Can everyone hear my voice? Let me just turn on the screen sharing here. Yes. Where's my MT4? Okay, yes, audio and video is good. Okay, great, great. How is everybody? Good, good, good. Okay, just before we begin here, how many of you guys are new? It's your first time in any of my webinars or any of our webinars at Urban Forex. Raul Smith, Minto, Paolo, Dan. Okay, great, great. So welcome to the community. You guys will probably notice that this is a really closed community where everybody is tied together, and we make sure we look out for everybody as much as we can. So again, welcome to the community, and today what we're going to do is discuss a strategy around support and resistance. Now, last time I taught you guys how we do support and resistance, and many of you guys requested, okay, now it's time for a strategy. Okay, so we're going to discuss that. Now, before we get into the strategy part, let me get into a little base recap of support and resistance again. And what we're going to do is, as we go through all of this, this is going to be a 1 hour, pretty much a 1 hour webinar. We're going to split the webinar as the first half as a learning experience and the last half as an interaction, and we'll keep all the questions to in the middle and towards the end of the webinar. Okay, if there is any audio issues, let me know. Here, let me reset the audio one more time, see if that helps. One moment. How many of you guys have actually audio issues? Can you make the candles darker? Yes, I can. Okay, I've reset the audio. It should be fine. If it's still not fine, this is recorded, so not to worry there. Okay, for those of you who need a darker charts, let me make them dark for you. All right, great. Yeah, sorry, Mark, but it's recorded, so not to worry there. Now, base recap on support and resistance. Now, okay, the traditional books, when you learn support and resistance, is they tell you that the area where the market turned around from is your level of support or resistance. You know, for example, here, this would be considered your resistance, or up here, this would be your resistance. You know, this area down here would be your support. Okay. Now, this is the traditional saying that this is your support, this is your resistance, okay? Anything below the current market is called support. Anything above the current market is called resistance. Now, that's not the way I particularly do it, and I've introduced this method to hundreds, in fact, thousands of people now, that you know, the way you do support resistance is not that way, okay? And here's why. Support and resistance, like anything else, works with level of strength, okay? There is a million support resistance. You can technically draw resistance on top of each candle if you want to really get into the nitty-gritty of it, and you'll just go crazy and be like, okay, this is resistance, resistance, and sooner or later you become like Einstein, you know, crazy hairdo. So you don't want to do that. You don't want to do that. You want to understand the level of strength of particular support and resistance level. Now, if you guys want to take notes, take notes. Support and resistance, the best levels consist of three things. That same particular level that you draw must be a level that has been used as support, and it must be a level that has been used as resistance. And finally, the third thing, there must have been a big candle that broke through it at one point. These are the three things for support and resistance. Let me give you an example. Okay, let's take a look sort of into the past. Let's get you some tips and clues. Okay, now for example, we take a look at this area here. Okay, I'm Mayor Rosie. The everything is recorded in case it's still okay. Let me do this. Let me turn off the VPN. See if that makes a difference. One moment, please. Give it a second. And okay, how about now? Is it better now? Hopefully. Okay. I'm going to repeat this one more time, and we'll see, hopefully it's better or not. If not, just wait for the recording. Okay, the three things for support and resistance. Information, okay, the first thing. The level that you draw must have been used as support. It must have been used as resistance. Okay, and last but not least, there must have been a big candle break from this level, which indicates this level being strong. Okay, let's go through this example. Now, how are you supposed to draw support and resistance? Is it just this tip here? Okay, the answer is no. Support and resistance can range from the body all the way up to the tail. Okay. What is a tail? A tail is basically telling you that the market tried to push, but it could not close, or it came down and closed. So if I draw on this particular body, at the top of this body, do you see any single body coming out of this area? No, right? For 2 days, nonstop, not a single body was able to come out of this area. It pushed, but it wasn't able to close outside of it, which means this area has just as much a strength as does the tip. This is how you create a range. You always need a range when you're drawing support resistance. It is not the traditional one line method that is taught. Okay? Because if I say the support is at 1.2555, your chart 1.2555 is not the same as my chart. Your broker's numbers are different than mine's. Okay, so you always need a range to get a sense of idea. Okay, our charts might be different, but it's not going to be 100 pips of difference. It's going to be a few pips. This is why you always need to have a range. Next thing, when you draw this area, okay, this is your resistance. It's above the market. So resistance. Over here, we had a big candle break. One big candle breaks through. This indicates that this level that we drew is a strong level. Okay, this is a strong level that we just broke through. Okay, now we've had resistance, big candle breaks here. Also, take a look, big candles coming through this area. Did we have support? You know, we had resistance. Let's go back and check. Did we have support in this area? Let's go back. Oh, well, what do you know? Take a look at this. You see how this entire area of 28 January, 29 January gets covered? Okay, covers both of these areas as support. So we have support, we have resistance, and a big candle break. Oh, sorry. Let's go forward. We've had a big candle break as well. So this area now indicates, now that we've crossed through, now even once the market crosses through, the traditional method that explains is once you cross a level, that level becomes the opposite. Okay, this was resistance. It broke through a big candle. Now it became support. Okay, this, because we know this area is strong, we're going to be using this area in the near future also. And the market tends to respect it, not once, but twice, and on and on and on. Because you know this level is strong and it's been coming in from the past for quite some time. Okay, now, the strategy part. Everyone understands support and resistance until now? Everyone with me so far? Okay, now let's get into the fun part. Okay, we're going to get into the strategy part. When do you draw support and resistance? That's the question. Okay. Yeah, I drew support resistance on the past, you know, yada, yada, yada. I get it. How do you know if the market is running that you need to draw a support and resistance level? When do you need to do it? Let's take a look. I'll show you. How many of you guys are familiar with divergence? Divergence, hidden divergence, you know, any other words that are attached to it. Okay. I've also explained it in the previous webinar, I think. Okay, for those of you who don't know it, no problem. We'll go into it right now. All right. Now, let's take a look. For divergence, I like to use an indicator called stochastics. Okay, I'm going to go to Insert, Indicator, go down to Trend, and it's in your list. Oh, sorry. Go down to Oscillators, and it's in your list here called Stochastic Oscillator. I click on that. I use standard settings, which is 533, whatever it is. I click OK. And this is how it looks on my screen. Now, let me remove this period separators so the charts are even more clean. Okay, perfectly clean. You guys see just the charts and the indicator now, right? Now let's go through this. Now, take a look at this thing right here. Let me show you an example of how a divergence or, okay, we're gonna use the word opposite in this webinar. Okay, what I'm gonna say opposite is if the price is doing opposite of the stochastics, that means price is going to change directions. Okay, I'm gonna repeat that one more time. If price is doing opposite than what the indicator is doing, price will change directions. Okay, so I'm not going to use the word divergence, hidden divergence, confluence, and all of that nonsense. I'm going to simply use the word opposite. Okay, now let's take a look at these charts. Now the markets are coming down. We create our first low. Okay, I'm going to mark this low. I draw my line saying that, okay, I have my low. Right? Everyone see that? This is a peak right here. We're going to do the same thing on our indicator. I'm going to mark the low on the indicator. This is the lowest point. Lowest. The market continues to move. It moves up. And then it starts to go down. As it starts to go down, we have what we call a breach. We've gone below our recent low, right? We've crossed. Now, is that the same case in our indicator? Have we crossed below this line at any time? No. We don't have the breach here. Since we were going in a downward movement, we're going to connect our bottoms. Okay. When you're going in an upward movement, connect your tops. When you're going in a downward movement, connect your bottoms. We're going to connect our bottoms. Okay. This is our first breach. It was here. And we're going to do the same with our indicator around that time the market was here or so somewhere, let's say. And you can see that the price is telling you it's in a downtrend, while the indicator is telling you it's in an uptrend. What we have is opposite. When you have opposite, price tends to change directions. Okay, in this particular case, price was going down, boom, price changes and goes up. This is just an example I'm showing you right now. I'm going to go in through one more example and then we'll get into putting this together with support and resistance. All right. We can actually use this and this. Let me get you a more clear example. There's tons of examples of this there, and trying to get you guys the most easy to understand. Yes, I will. We'll do it on US dollar Japanese yen also. Could you do it on a US dollar or Japanese yen? Yes, I will. Okay, so let's take a look at this. The market comes here, creates a high, then it goes down. Okay, I'm gonna mark this high right here. I'm gonna do the same on my indicator. Market comes down, goes up, we have a breach. We've gone higher than our previous high. Not the case in our indicator. It's not gone higher than our previous high. We have opposite. Since we were going in an upward movement, we're going to connect our highs. At that particular time, we only saw this candle. We didn't see this candle. From here, at that point, we were around here somewhere. Opposite, right? From here to here, totally opposite things. Indicator saying downward movement while price is saying upward movement. Okay, since price is in an upward movement and we have opposite, means price is going to turn around. In this particular case, price takes a reverse. Okay, everyone understand the concept of opposite or divergence so far? Okay. Now, let's put this into action. I'm going to remove this line, since we already know there's a divergence now, or opposite. And we see it's clearly at this point we have this information. The timing is actually immediate, but Mark, I will explain that situation to you. Now, when you have the situation of opposite, remember, if you're just looking at this information of divergence, what happens is you're relying on your indicator, which is deadly. Never rely on your indicator. Okay? Now, in this particular case, the indicator is at this particular moment when this candle actually went up, the chances are the indicator didn't cross. We don't know if the indicator is going to go down. What if the market actually continues going higher? And the indicator continues going higher too. You would never know that this is a divergence then. What you do is you need to, at this moment when this happens and you're like, there is a possible divergence, start drawing. Mark this area with your line and check. Is this an area of support and resistance? Let's check it out. Let's go into the past and see what is this area. If we can get that far, let's see. Should I shrink it more? See if that helps. Maybe 4 hour charts would help. Wow, okay. We don't have any data going further back other than probably the daily charts. That's okay. This example is gonna be a little bit difficult to explain, but let me use an example that we did today earlier for Forex Watchers people in our conference room. What time frame do you draw the line? You begin with 1 hour and you work your way up. I'm going to explain to you guys that thing right now. In our conference room at Forex Watchers, we were looking at the 4 hour chart today on EURUSD. Okay, this is in fact why I have a trade running. Now take a look at this. I'm going to remove all these lines. I'm going to zoom in a little bit more. Take a look at this. We have a high here. We mark our high. We have a high here, we mark our high. Price is going down as it's coming upwards. Price is coming upwards, indicator comes up. We have a breach. Now, we have a breach on the indicator, but we don't have a breach on our price. What we're gonna do is we're gonna draw, since we're going upwards, we're gonna draw our tops from here to at that point was here. We're going to do the same with our tops here, from here to this area. Does that look like opposite to you? Okay. This indicates price is possibly going to reverse and turn around in the direction it's going. The direction it was going was long. And we wanted to say we have a short. When the short is coming up, that's the million-dollar question. That's the reason why we implement support resistance. So I draw my line here first. And I'm like, okay, What can I know about this area? Okay. Yes, George, in a downward movement, you draw the bottom. See, you see how price is moving upwards here? As price is moving upwards, you draw the tops. If the last immediate trend, if it's moving downwards, you draw the bottoms. Does that make sense? Okay, we'll do more examples, don't worry. All right. Now, so I draw my line here as I see this potential divergence, because I don't know that the stochastics is going to cross or not. I don't know if it's going to do that. All I know, all I can assume is maybe the market continues going long and then it's no longer a opposite, you know? So I draw my line here. I'm like, what is so significant about this area? And then I check. Okay, so I draw my range, right? I take this area, maybe I take the tail also, and I start refining by looking in the past. I go back and I'm like, okay, we have a big candle coming out of here. We have a big candle coming out of here. We have resistance. Let's take it a little bit lower so we can cover the bodies. Okay, we have resistance. We have support. Let's go further back. Okay. So we have support again. We have a big candle break again. Okay, interesting. Let's go further back. We're going. Where are we going to end up? Okay, now the next question you guys are going to ask me, how far do you look back? You know, I get this question a lot. It's up to you. Until it takes you to satisfy yourself. Okay, big candle breaches here. Big candle breach here. Markets halt right here. Markets halt above or below. But during this period, you have big candle breaches. Remember, a big candle breach indicates a strong level has been broken. Okay, let's go further back if you want. Okay, take a look at this. Complete support. We're going all the way to 16th of November. Yeah. Until three rules are done. Once you have three rules, you're good. No, you have support, you have resistance, you have a big candle break, and you're up in 28th November. So this level has been holding all the way back from last year. You know, it's not really magic, but you know, that's it. So you come back down to the current area, and you're like, okay, this is my area I want to sell from. So we took a sell, and the markets are now headed short. Everyone with me so far? Everyone understand this concept? Okay. So now always remember one thing. When you're doing this on certain currency pairs, try to do them on all three time frames. When I say all three time frames is, if you're a 15-minute guy, do it 15, 30, and 1 hour. If you're a 1 hour person, do it 1 hour, 4 hours, and daily. Okay, in this particular case, the 4 hour says short, as per the divergence, or opposite. We take a look at the, let's take a look at the daily. Okay, do we have any sort of information on the daily? Vadi Villan, you can check out the video again. Maybe that will help you if you watch it a couple of times. Okay, markets are going down. If we draw a downtrend here, if we draw a downtrend here, it's the same, right? Our indicator and information is saying the same thing. Okay. So, basically, our daily chart has nothing confusing. Our 4 hour charts have opposite information. Our 1 hour charts currently has nothing, but take a look at this. We have a bottom here, right? Kumar, 1 hour and above is my preference. We have a bottom here. Do you think we might have a possible breach? Hey, it's possible. If the indicator goes below this area, that means we've gone below our previous low. But on price, look how far the previous low is. How far is that low? That's like 46 pips away. Okay, it's already dropped, 45 pips. That's another 46 pips for it to drop today. Seems unlikely. There we go. Take a look at this. Next candle just opened, right? You see this? Do we have a divergence now or an opposite? We have a breach live in front of us. Everyone see it now? Okay. Now, what is the next thing we do? Now that we see this breach, what is the next thing that we do? Check support and resistance. Very good, Kong. Is it Kang or Kong? Which one? I'm sorry if I'm saying it wrong. All right, so I draw my first line here. Okay, if I'm saying it wrong, or just correct me. All right, I draw my first line here. I'm like, I wonder what is this area? Do you think the market's going to stop here? I don't know. Well, let's check. We have some resistance. We have a big candle break. So we have this piece of information. What about our support? Okay, so now, let me remove this bottom line, sorry. Okay, we can refine this a little bit. Let's bring this a little bit higher here. Okay, and we need to get our bottom area too. Okay, now we're covering a lot of grounds. See here? Hello, Will. Now we're covering a lot of grounds, you see here. We have a big candle break. Big candles coming out of this area. That's okay, Will. We're recording it, so not to worry. You can see a lot of level of resistance here that's covered. Resistance, big candle breaks again. Let's go further back. Support. Take a look how well the support's holding this whole time. Okay. Are we out by the support a little bit? Let's move it down a little bit. And let's see if this is our little range here. Okay. Okay, it looks a little bit more messy like this, but I'm going to move it back to where it was. Okay, this seems to be my ideal spot, right? Lorex, yes, this is going to be on YouTube in the next 30 or so hours. It'll be on YouTube. And yeah, if you're watching this on YouTube, please like the video and comment and share your feedbacks. Okay, so we have support, we have resistance, and not to mention we have a big candle breaks. Okay, so this area holds again and again and again in the past, in the future, not in the future as of yet. But this area just keeps holding and breaks by a big area, a big candle. So my initial thought process is this is the area that I'm expecting the markets to go long from. Does everyone see how I came to this conclusion? Okay. So that means my current short that I have running, I'm going to have to go ahead and close. Because I'm getting a mixed piece of sentiments around this area where I don't see the short continuing very long. If I look at my 4 hours, you know, the 4 hours is still going short, okay? It could be another candle or two. And if that's the case, we need to find another area below it if this area happens to breach. But as of right now, this area looks like it has a lot of strength because look how much market is contained here, okay? So that's our immediate reaction. Now, that's that. Okay, we just closed one trade. Now, I think US dollar CAD. Was it CAD that we had a different scenario? All right. Let's take a look at another pair to see if we have any other information. Let's see. US dollar CAD. You want to look at pound? Okay, let's take a look at pound. Pound is currently short, right? This was the last short area. This was the last short area. The current market is also low. So it's on a downward movement. So you want to connect your lows from here to here. Okay, but you have the same thing. You don't have opposite situation here. You have a low to a further low. You don't have an opposite scenario. Okay. You need to have an opposite scenario first. Then the next thing you want to do is you want to make sure you pick the right support and resistance once that happens. And the way to do that is to confirm that your support resistance satisfy those three criteria: resistance, support, and a big candle break. Okay, I believe one of you guys said you guys want to do US dollar Japanese yen. Let's take a look at US dollar Japanese yen. Let's go down to the 1 hour. Let's do, I want to do a black chart. I think Lisa, you wanted it in a little bit darker. Okay, so let's take a look. Let's insert the indicator. There we go. Do we possibly have a breach happening right now? Let's see. We have our high. We do the possible high here. We need a candle to go slightly higher to give us our breach, a proper breach that will say it's now saying opposite scenarios. Let's check the 4 hours to see what is a higher time frame telling us. Okay, any indications on the higher time frame? We're in a downward movement. When you're in a downward movement, you connect your lows. If you connect your lows, you have a higher low. And if you do the same thing here, you have a higher low. No, nothing really is saying opposite. Let's check daily to get an idea from a longer term side. Same scenario, the markets are in an uptrend and this one is pretty much sideways or slightly up. It doesn't. The area. You would have to start drawing, right? To see that which area matches up. Okay, if you draw, for example, this area as your support resistance, you need to check in the past to see, does this area hold true in the past? You know, 14th February, 13th February, yes. Big candle break on 15th, okay. You know, big candle breaks over here, okay. Big candle break here, okay. So far we have resistance and big candle break. We're looking for support, and then we have some whipsaw here. So chances are this might not be a good area. Okay, it has some strength, but not the ideal strength. Okay, so another thing is whenever you're in doubt, don't trade. Okay, that's the rule of thumb. Whenever in doubt, don't trade. Okay. And you can see probably as the candles move, your divergence thing will also, I mean, your indicator will also move as your price moves. So it's very important that you make sure that it's a very clear opposite. Okay, when I say clear, it needs to stick out to a point where you're like, for it not to be clear, the price has to move a lot. Okay, same scenario that we had with Euro USD. Okay. All right, so now anyone pick a pair. We're going to work on a particular pair that you guys pick. We just did pound, Will. Euro-yen? Okay, let's take a look at euro-yen. And pound-yen, okay. So we'll look at euro-yen and pound-yen. Okay, we're going to start with 1 hour. How do you define a big candle? Now, the big candle has to be more than the average candle. For example, is this a big candle? Oh, sorry. All right, Hassan. Is this a big candle? Okay. Now, the reason why you said no without even looking at the amount of pips is because you're comparing the size to the nearby candles. Right? You do the same thing when you're looking for a big candle. You compare the size to the nearby candles and see, is it a big candle or not? So, for example, these trades, these candles, they're all small candles. Okay, this would be considered a big candle. This is considered a big candle. Abby, Naveen, I thought price has to move first before indicator moves. What makes indicator to move and price lags behind so that divergence forms? Well, Abby, you can have it vice versa. You know, when you have the opposite or a divergence scenario, you can either have prices lagging or you can have the indicators lagging. This is just indicating there's a shift in direction coming up. It's another way of saying the market's oversold or overbought. That's it. But it's more of like towards a price action technique because you're not really using the indicator's original methods of buy and sell. Okay. All right. Now, sorry, we were doing euro yen. Let's take a look at the current market situations. Another thing to look at is make sure when you're doing your opposite trading, make sure you have at least something that is almost near the overbought, oversold area. You know, if you're trading from movements that are within this area, chances are that the divergence is going to be weak. So try to trade them, try to get the divergence as far out as possible, the ones that are near the oversold or near the overbought. You know, it helps you get a better direction. Okay, current market conditions, it's going downwards, so we want to connect our highs. Okay, our tops, if you want to call them. It's this way. Same thing here, this way. Nothing really changes. Okay, moving forward, 4 hours. Let's take a look. Tops, straight. Tops, down. Okay, not opposite. Okay, make sure you have a clear opposite when you want to do this. Naveen, I see a divergence on Euro pound now. Okay, let's take a look at Euro pound if there is a clear example. Let's see, Euro pound. Okay, let the chart load up one moment. Oh, on the daily chart. Okay. Okay, well, forget the daily chart. We have something here also on the 1 hour chart. Take a look at this. The markets are in an upward movement. Markets went long. We're going to connect our highs. Okay. We had our breach when it went long here. Markets closed. You draw your line here. Okay, so the daily chart tells you short. You know, that's the long-term movement. Long-term movement tells you short. I'm sorry, the 1 hour. Sorry, this is the 1 hour chart. The 1 hour chart tells you short. Let's move on to the 4 hours. Let this load up. Give it a moment. Sorry. There we go. Okay. No specific divergence on the 4 hours. Okay, it's an upward movement. Markets are also going upward on the indicators. There's nothing really fancy there. Moving out to finally onto the daily chart. Pistol, is there a setting that can help tell the number of pips to take? No. This is something you need to understand using support and resistance. Where is the area for exit? Ken, we just looked at Euro Yen, right? Okay, I'll take a look at Euro Yen one more time if you guys want, but let this load one moment. We'll take a look at Pound Yen as well, sorry. So after this, we'll look at Pound Yen and then we'll look back at Euro Yen. Okay, now this is loaded. Now take a look at this. Okay, we had our breach just now on the current candle. And in this particular scenario, we don't have that situation here. Now the indicator has to go higher than this high for it not to be a opposite or divergence. We need to find out what is it about this area that tells you short. The 1 hour is telling you short as well. So is the daily. What is it about this area? Let's check. Is there anything that comes in from the past? Okay. We have some pieces of information. Let's draw our lines. Now, where is the current price? Okay, the price is right up there. Okay, so around this price, we want to look for an area. Where does the market start touching? Okay, we see there's a lot of resistance here. Okay, big chunk of mess around this area. Lots of support and resistance. Okay, so let's redefine this. Okay. That we want to monitor in this area, you find the best one. Okay. Let me draw our areas here so you guys can get an idea. Okay, we're gonna scroll back from here and see what is actually contained in this area. Okay, well, for starters, we have this. Very good area. Let's go further back. Let me use the 4 hour chart, sorry. Okay. Okay, this is the area that we were drawing everything from, right? We have our top line, we have our bottom line. Redefine it a little bit more. Okay, there we go. Now we have a little bit strict containment of price and markets. Remember, these big candles breaking through, that's fine. Big candles are welcome. Okay. But we have the certain amount of market being contained here. So this is the area where we're possibly seeing a turnaround from. Markets can possibly go short somewhere around here, turn around and go long into our next area, which is up here, where you'll see the drop happen on a longer term frame, longer time frame, which then the drop might come down to probably somewhere around here. Okay. Naveen, is there a divergence and proper support resistance zone on Swiss franc market? Let's take a look. Okay, after this one, we do pound yen. Sorry. We'll just take a look at this real quick. Okay. Yes, we do. Take a look at this area. We have a low. We have a breach. We have a low. We don't have a breach. Okay, since the markets were going down, you connect your lows. When the breach happened, the market was going down, so you connect your lows. You do the same thing here. At that time, the indicator should have been here somewhere. Totally opposite. So you're like, okay, somewhere around here, the markets are gonna go long. Where is your question? You start drawing your lines and you start looking back to test. It's like, where in the world is this area? Now, okay, so you take a look at this area, you're like, huh. Okay, we have some strong levels of resistance. Big candle breaks, perfect. Okay, can we draw our upper range? Okay, let's draw it. Let's get this upper range here as well. Okay, now we're defining an area. Okay, let's go further back. Well, what do you know? Let's go further back. Boom. Support and resistance contained. Okay. I'm not making this stuff up. It's just natural. Support and resistance is simply the way to do it. Take a look. Market tends to repeat itself again and again and again. You see? So this level is clearly a strong level, right? Okay. Big candles breaking through. Perfect. We want big candles to break through. A big candle is a representation that this is a strong level. Markets contained. Okay. So coming back down to the current price, we're like, okay, around this area is my area to possibly go long. Okay, in this zone. As the markets go long here, you place your trade to go long, and the markets are currently long. Now, at the same time, what is the trend of, let's take a look at 18th of February. The market goes up, then down, then sideways. Euro USD, 18th of February, where is my, Okay, it goes down, then up, then sideways. Is it doing the complete opposite thing? Do we have correlation? Okay, example. Swiss franc usually does everything opposite of Euro USD. Swiss franc on 18th of February goes up, then down, then sideways. Euro USD, it goes down, then up, then sideways. It's doing the exact opposite. Now, having this said, if you look at today's market, up, sideways, down. Swiss franc. Down, sidelined, up. Not to mention, our divergences for both strategies occurred at the same time. For both currency pairs, sorry. You see that difference? You see that change? Sorry. Euro USD gave you an divergence or opposite telling you short. Swiss franc gave you one at the same time telling you long. Now you have three levels of confirmation. You have your opposite, you have your support resistance, and you have correlation. Things are lining up. Okay? And markets are moving. The chances are, if you probably look at them on a higher time frame, these are probably seeing the same thing also. Let's take a look at the higher time frame. Okay, markets was going down. We have a low here. So when you're going downwards, mark your lows. Well, let's mark our lows. Opposite? Yes. Okay, you draw your zones, you contain the market, you have your area. This is a perfect way to practice your support and resistance. Whenever you have a divergence or opposite coming up, draw your support and resistance within days, very quickly. You will know which area of support resistance is strong by a good trade and a bad trade. You'll understand very quickly. And you'll start to draw them better and better and better. Okay, so guys, repeat, going over this thing. What are the three things for support and resistance? Abhinav, yes, you can do that as well. Okay, for example, I did this on the 4 hour. I draw these zones, right? If I go down to the 1 hour, take a look. It makes more sense because you're like, okay, there's a whole bunch of tails coming into this area. Okay. But it's nearby, Hassan. It's nearby. It's close enough. Which is better, confirm the divergence, MP or support resistance? Support resistance, obviously. MP is an indicator. I don't like indicators. Okay, this is a very powerful thing. Understanding your levels where the markets will halt. Because remember, forget the traditional methods of doing it. You know, the traditional methods are really outdated. You know, it's like from the Stone Age. The reality is you need to look for these three things. A level that's been used with support, a level that's been used with resistance, and a level that's been broken by a big candle, which indicates a strong breakout, a strong level has been broken. The Harami thing, Naveen? What is that? Abhinav, MP can't work alone. And Mark, so would you then address the final issue of timing the entry? Okay, when you have your divergence, the moment you have your divergence, you start plotting and looking for your nearby support and resistance, and you see if that is the ideal area. Something we did here on EURUSD, what we did was we drew it on the 4 hour charts. We had our divergence, clear divergence, and then we started plotting our levels of support resistance. So when it happened, we drew our lines. We're like, huh, what is this area? Okay, we had clear levels of resistance and clear levels of support. And big candle breaks. It had everything that we wanted. It was right here. Perfect spot for us to take a short. which we did, which you guys saw when you close in front of you. Candlestick patterns, bullish Harami, bearish Harami, doji. Oh, no. I don't. They're all pretty much the same thing. It's a headache. So yeah, it's 8:30 p.m. my time now. It's 7:30 a.m. New York City time. Any last minute questions? I can go through a few more last minute questions for 5 more minutes, and then we will close the webinar. Kilimanjaro, what is hidden divergence? Now, there's a difference between hidden and regular divergence. You know, one is where the price is the one that did the breach. In this particular case, who did the breach here? The indicator went higher than the previous high, not the price. See? And there is one where the indicator does the breach, and then the other one is where the price does the breach and not the indicator. That's the difference. Okay, and there's other ways where people actually, you know, the price goes lower high, but then they draw the bottoms, you know, there's nonsense like that also. So just think of them as opposite. The moment you have opposite, price is going to change directions. Does this strategy work on gold, stochastics, and support resistance? Yes, try them out. In fact, I would like to know. For those of you who like to practice this on, practice this on our, we have a page. If you actually go to the groups, just click on view all groups. And where to go? There's support and resistance. You can post all your trades here. You know, we have a bunch of people who are going to be responding and, you know, helping you out with this. And we have tons of trades and stuff like that in there as examples. So go ahead and use them. Post your trades. We'll help you out with it in case we do see any errors or anything like that. Okay, yes, 533. Yeah, just standard. Last question, do you hungry? Yes, I am hungry. It is my time. You know, whenever it's time for me to leave the webinar, food is my answer. You're very welcome, guys. All right, guys, it was great to see you all. And welcome to all you new members who have just joined the community. I hope you enjoy the community. If there's any questions, message me personally. It's fine. Use the discussion boards. Everyone is there to help you out. If you need anything, I will help you as fast as I can as I get to the emails myself. So good luck, everybody. And I will see you tomorrow. We have another webinar for Will Lee on supply and demand. So I will see many of you guys there tomorrow. Thanks, guys. Have a good night. And thank you. I will enjoy the dinner. Thanks. Bye now.